In this video, I want to recast our FIFO axiomatic system into the language of geometry. So you'll remember previously that with our FIFO axioms and axiomatic systems, we introduce these things called phis, and we introduce these things called foes. What we're going to do is actually, instead of calling them phis, we're now going to call them a point. So interchange the word phi with point, and interchange the word fo with line. There was also this relationship between phis and foes that we called belonging. So we'd say that a phi belongs to a fo. Well, now we're going to call that incidence. So we can say that a point is incident to a line. And so make that substitution there. Phis are points, foes are lines, belonging is incident. And then we changed nothing about the theory of phi and fo. What would that look like when we rebrand it as a geometric object? Because after all, points, lines, and incidents are undefined terms. So are phi, fo, and belonging. And so to be a geometer, we just have to have some notion of points, lines, and incidents, which phi, fo, if you rebrand it, does have that. So it turns out phi, fo theory is a geometry. And in fact, this is what we call three-point geometry. Where it gets its name is actually from the first axiom of FIFO theory. If we rebrand it using now lines, points, and incidence, the first axiom of FIFO theory, which let me remind you, the first axiom stated that there exists exactly three distinct phis in the system. Well, we can rewrite that as there exists exactly three distinct points, because phis are now points. And that's actually where it gets its name. We're calling this three-point geometry because we have the 3 points given by axiom one. Axiom two of FIFO theory told us that any two distinct phis belong to exactly one fo. Well, if we rebrand that using geometric terms, that turns into that becomes the sentence for each, for each two distinct points, there exists a unique line containing both of them. All right. Again, slightly different phrasing, but it means the exact same thing. We had the two phis, which are now points, and they're incidents to exactly one fo, which is now called a line. Axiom three of FIFO theory was not all phis belong to the same fo. Not all phis belong to the same fo. In lines and points, that actually turns out to be not all points lie on the same line. There's no line that contains all of the points. In other words, the entire set of points is a non-collinear set. All right. Then the last one, axiom four, FIFO theorem says that any two distinct foes contain at least one phi that belongs to them. Okay. I've actually really simplified the statement. I've actually written that axiom as all lines intersect, because if we took the exact language and just replace foes with lines and phis with points, we would get that any two distinct lines contain at least one point that belongs to both of them. Now that we've introduced the word intersect, which we didn't have for phis and foes, but if we introduce the word intersect, that axiom can be simplified using the definition to just be all lines intersect. Remember the axiomatic method. We first have undefined terms, then we have definitions, then we have axioms. The axioms come third on the list, and that's because the axioms themselves can use, in addition to the undefined terms, they can use the definitions that we've developed. Like in this case, the word intersect simplifies, it simplifies the axiom four here that all lines intersect. Given any two lines, there's at least one point on both of them. Now, the fourth step of the axiomatic method is then theorems. Once we have our axioms, we can then start proving theorems from them. Now, we proved 4 theorems for FIFO theory, just based upon the axioms. What we've done now with three-point geometry is we just now have a new interpretation of what phi and fo mean. We're interpreting phi as point and fo as line. And with those interpretations, then all four of the theorems then become theorems of our three-point geometry. And so they translate immediately, and we're going to look at them in just one moment. Before I do that, I want us to consider this diagram that you see here on the screen. This is actually meant to be a model of three-point geometry, and hence is also a model of FIFO theory, for which these little circles you see here are supposed to be illustrations of what we mean by points. So we have three circles, three dots. Those represent the 3 points. These straight segments you see here then represent our lines. And so we have three lines that you see right here. We have the 3 points that you see right here. Incidence is then indicated that if a line touches the 2 points, if a line touches a point, we say it's incidence to that point. So if we focus on this point right here, this line is incident to it, and this line is incident to it. Similarly, if we look at this point right here, this line is incident to it, this line is incident to it. And so from this diagram, this graph we see on the screen, for which we have vertices and edges, we can use a graph to illustrate a finite geometry for which we get the incidence relations directly from it. So this is in fact a model of three-point geometry. I want you to convince yourself of that. We have axiom one, 3 points, great. For each pair of points, there exists a unique line that contains both of them. So if you look at this pair, there's only one line that contains both of them. If you look at this pair, there's only one line that contains both. If you look at this pair, there's only one line that contains both. So axiom two is satisfied. Axiom three, not all points lie on the same line. If you look at all 3 points together, there's no line that harbors all three of them. The set of all points is non-collinear. And then lastly, all lines intersect. If you take these two lines, they intersect at this point. If you take these two lines, they intersect at this point. If you take these two lines, they intersect at this point. And so this is in fact a model of three-point geometry. And therefore it's also a model of FIFO theory. And as we discussed FIFO theory in the previous lecture, we actually discovered that the theory was complete. That is, up to isomorphism, there's only one model. And therefore, this is the only model of three-point geometry up to isomorphism. Now let's take a look at those four theorems I had mentioned beforehand. I'm going to zoom out a little bit so we can see the picture of the model and the theorems as well. So look at the first theorem here. In three-point geometry, and so I'm going to start all these theorems with that statement, in three-point geometry. So we know that these theorems are not broad theorems for all geometry. It's only for the three-point geometry theory we're studying right now. In three-point geometry, each line has exactly 2 points that belong to it. You'll notice this line has 2 points, this line has 2 points, and this line has 2 points. It's very easy to see from the model, but if we want to prove it from the theorem, for the theory, we need to prove it from the axioms. Because how do we know there aren't different models than this one? I said the theory is complete, but that's only because of these four theorems. From these four theorems, we can derive that every model is isomorphic to this one. All right, the second theorem of FIFO, which becomes a theorem of three-point geometry, states that a line is completely characterized by the points on it. That is, if two lines are distinct, then they do not contain the same points. So if you look at these two lines right here, notice they have different points. If you look at these two lines, notice they have different points. If you look at these two lines, you'll notice they have two different points. So no two lines contain the exact same points, all right? So a line is actually determined, it's characterized by the points it's incidence to. So we actually could have defined lines to be sets of points. There would be no difference in the theory if we had done that. Theorem three in three-point geometry, two distinct lines intersect at exactly 1 point. So axiom four told us that all lines intersect, in which we check, they all do. But furthermore, we know that the intersection is unique. You don't get something like the following, where you could have two lines that intersect at two different points. We don't have anything like that in the picture. That's easy to see. And then the last one, in three-point geometry, there are exactly three distinct lines for which we prove this in general, and that's true for a model because this is the only model up to isomorphism. So with the right perception, many axiomatic theorems can be thought of as geometries. As long as we have a notion of line and point, then we have a geometry. And so our FIFO theory is also a geometric theory. And so going forward, we're never going to talk about fees and foes again. We'll just talk about three-point geometry. And in the next video, we'll introduce another finite geometry that we haven't yet seen so far.